Hi, welcome to Raw Math and my series of videos on exponential functions. This question is talking about cockroaches. In this problem, we have a graph, and the explanation on the graph is that this represents the number of cockroaches in a part of the city. And their crossing point is, it starts with one. Okay. So what we want to do is we want to figure out if this represents 15 days, there after 15 days there's 200 cockroaches. One, what is our growth rate? And two, how many cockroaches do we have after 30 days? So what we're going to do is we're first going to say that the 15 day growth rate is 200. Because how you get from 1 to 200 with multiplication is multiply by 200. But we want to go from 15 days down to 1 day. So we are going to take this and say 200 to the 1 over 15, which is going to give us the number 1.424. And then to get the growth rate, we subtract 1 and multiply by 100. So we subtract 1, multiply by 100. It's 42.4% growth rate per day. Now, if you're wondering and you're thinking, hey, if the 15-day rate is 200 and we want to know 30 days, couldn't we just double it? So if we wrote the equation cockroaches over time, we start with 1, we don't need to write it, and the growth factor is 200, as long as you take the number of days and divide it by 15, which is very much like what we have here, then when we go up to 30, cockroaches over 30 days is 200 to 30 over 15, which is 200 squared, and 200 squared is 2 times 2 is 4, and double the zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it's 40,000 cockroaches. The answer is sure, you could do that. But we had to go down to the 1 day to get the growth rate. So here's a really good time to check if doing the equations in two different forms will really give us the same answer. And remember, these are all guesstimations. So if we did the cockroaches per day, we still start with 1, but then our growth factor is this 1.424 per day. So cockroaches after 30 days is 1.424 to the 30, which is going to equal 40,300. Those numbers are really, really close. You have to assume that this was rounded, and considering this is a little bit bigger, I assume that it was really 1.423 something. So it was rounded up, but the numbers are really close, and both answers work for a basic prediction. So after 30 days, there will be about 40,300 cockroaches. Now, we have two parts of our answer. We have our sentence here and we have our growth rate here. This right here is proof positive why it is really, really important to show your work. There are two acceptable answers to this problem depending on what method you chose to get there. And if you don't show your work, it's impossible for the instructor who's grading your work to know if you did the work and if you know what you're doing. And if my answer key had this 40,300, because this is the method that the majority of students use, and somebody comes and gives the 40,000 without any work shown, I might not give them credit, not because I doubt they did it right, but if I have one answer on my answer key and I assume everyone's doing it the way I've taught in class, then I'm grading based on my answer key and the assumed method of approach. That doesn't mean in my class I wouldn't accept the first one. I would absolutely accept that as an approach. I just wouldn't expect students to do that. So if a student did a different approach than what we generally do in class, which is going down to the one unit and manipulating the one unit, if I don't see the work, I can't give the credit. That's the big thing in math. You need to see the work to know where the answer came from. All right, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, like my Facebook page, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks.